Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 16.4 Beta 4 has been out for a few days. I've been using it full-time on my iPhone 14 Pro Max and also my iPad Pro. I wanted to talk about the overall experience, not just my experience, but your experience based on the YouTube community poll, where there's over 6,000 votes and over 100 comments. We'll talk about that. We'll also talk about some new apps and changes to those, but first let's start with some new features. Now the first new feature in Beta 4 I wanted to mention has to do with photos. Now there's some changes in photos, but also visual lookup is coming to more places. So visual lookup looks at landmarks and gives you more information about them based on the photos you've taken. And you can see here's the bridge that I took a picture of quite some time ago. And apparently this is working in the Philippines now. If it's working for you in a different region where it didn't before though, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Also, if you go into settings and under settings, if you scroll down until you find Game Center, the first time you go into Game Center, you'll actually get a new splash screen. I missed this in the initial What's New video as I didn't notice it, but you have one that shows up that talks about activity widget and also activity access. So just some new features with Beta 4 or iOS 16.4. There also seems to be a new splash screen with stocks depending on how many times you open it. Sometimes it shows up, sometimes it doesn't. Now, if you've taken a photo or maybe just gone into the Photos app to edit maybe today's wallpaper, and I'll link this in the description like I normally do, but as you can see here, if we modify this, just change it a little bit, maybe go to the next one, change it a little bit, hit done, and then go back to edit, we can revert back. Some people are seeing this actually show a little icon that looks more of what reminds me of iOS 7. Instead of the actual word revert, they're seeing a little icon for it. So let me know if you're seeing that. I'm not seeing it, but some people are actually seeing that based on maybe the amount of different things they have at the bottom that have been adjusted. So if you are seeing it, let me know in the comments below. And on Twitter, my friend Steve Mosier posted the first one. I mentioned this in the initial What's New video, where the MLS season pass image was added to the TV app. You can see that here in the season pass. And if you want to subscribe to MLS season pass, you can, and it's just giving more updates to that with more wording changes there as well. Additionally, he also mentions miscellaneous changes, including Apple Pay Later that we're still waiting for. And also you can see that some of the code was compiled on March 6th. So this was done maybe before they released it. That's pretty typical though, that some of the code has been compiled before. So that's a slight change. Now, also, if we go into settings and then we go to our name at the top, if we scroll down and go to advanced data protection, these icons have been reverted back. Now, I've talked about this before where we thought maybe they were getting ready for iOS 17 and changing the icons to match what we have on macOS, where they're more of sort of a neomorphic design with maybe more depth. That's something I would love to see brought back, but they've reverted back to flat icons with the messages backup and also voice memos. Hopefully this changes in the future, but maybe iOS 17 will get this, maybe it won't, and it was just a mistake. Hopefully they just realized we pushed those out too early and we'll fix it later. Now, as far as some things I wanted to mention, first Apple news is Apple Maps gets an update for all of the people on iOS. So if you're in Apple Maps and you go to the city Boston, Apple continues to update it with updated maps. So in this case, if we zoom in here on Fenway Park or any landmark, it will not only give you information about it, but there's detailed 3D models about it as well. So that's something that's been updated here as well. Now, this past week, of course, the yellow iPhone launched. I mentioned that in a different video where I actually unboxed it, and it's just a different color, but it's an iPhone 14. I was really disappointed that they didn't release Pro models with a new color, whether it's yellow or red or something else, but hopefully they do maybe next year. They did last year with green. This year there was nothing. Now, if you subscribe to YouTube TV, that's getting a price bump. So I wanted to go over some new app updates as well, where YouTube TV is going up to $73 per month. Now, if you have YouTube TV and you were paying $65 per month, that price will increase on April 18th. So unfortunately, the price is going up and it's more expensive now than different cable plans from providers such as Spectrum and more. So that's a bit of a disappointment, as many cord cutters were actually using different apps like I have, Apple TV Plus, Hulu, Netflix, now YouTube TV is just more expensive. Now, Apple Music Classical is being mentioned more and more, and it's in the browse section under Apple Music. So if you go into browse, you'll see it here. I did mention this in the initial What's New video, but you can pre-order it. It's coming out soon on March 28th. That hints at maybe a release date for iOS 16.4. We'll talk about that in a little bit though. Also, something else is last week I mentioned how MLB's app was actually getting live activities. This time around, the NBA app is getting that. So if we go back into settings and scroll down to NBA, you can go into live activities. Now, these were enabled by default, but it allows for live activities on your lock screen. And also, if you have a 14 Pro or 14 Pro Max, it will actually show live activities in the dynamic island, giving an update on scores. So it's nice to see more and more apps utilize this. I think sports is one of the best places for this, but we're seeing this used more and more. Also, a new app I wanted to mention is called Landmarks. This actually uses landmarks from Apple Maps and gives you more information about it, such as the Los Angeles International Airport. And if we go to the next, you have the New York Stock Exchange, you have the Transamerican Pyramid, and different ones around the world. So you can go back and search for what you want in any different city where they have different landmarks. So if we pick maybe Sydney, you've got the Harbor Bridge, you have the Opera House, and these are all drawn by Apple for their Maps update. So it's really nice here that we have these, and you can see that within Maps. But it's a free app. I'll link it in the description if you want to check it out. Now, if you're using the Apple Store app, so if we go into Apple Store, wait for it to load. It's taking a moment here. If maybe we go into iPhone 14, we now have the option not only to chat with an iPhone specialist, but in the United States, we can actually sort of browse visually over video with an iPhone specialist. Now, they won't see your video feed, but you can see theirs. You can talk to them and maybe get an idea of size comparison between a 14 Pro Max, a 14 Pro, and different phones if you're trying to figure out what's right for you and you want to shop virtually. So that's something they're offering in the US now. Again, you have to go to the Apple Store's website or the app, and you can chat and maybe do that visually if you want to shop with someone through video. Now, with all the recent updates with ChatGPT-4, Bing integration, and now Google integrating their own AI solution, Bing and things like that are gaining more information to give you a better experience. And this is apparently in the works with Apple. Apple's working on their own version of AI to help out with Siri, and Apple opted for security, but that's really slowed down the advancement of Siri compared to others. So hopefully we'll see something with iOS 17 or maybe later, but Apple actually had an AI sort of meeting for internal people there at the Steve Jobs Theater a couple weeks ago. So maybe they'll integrate something like that. Maybe it's a different version. We don't really know, but they definitely need to do something, as Google and Microsoft and of course Amazon, they'll all leap above what Apple has to offer soon if they don't do something. So hopefully they update that soon. Also, one bit of news I wanted to mention is Apple is coming out with its own 5G modem. A few years ago, we had Intel modems in our phones, and those weren't that great. Apple opted to go with 5G with Qualcomm, and Qualcomm gets a little bit of money for each one of those. After they stopped the Intel deal, Intel stopped making those modems, and they bought all of the patents. Now they're working on their own, and hopefully that will make for a much better power solution, meaning we'll have better performance and battery life overall, like they've done with their Apple chips. So we have their silicon, where we have the M1 processors, M2, we have the A8, and all the way up to the latest one. So they've been making their own processors for a while, and they seem to be leaps above what anyone else can do. Hopefully they get this right, but it seems that it's going to launch with the iPhone SE 4, if the current information is correct. But either way, Apple's definitely working on it. Hopefully it rolls out sooner rather than later. Now, we've got 4 beta versions of iOS 16.4, and we're currently on a build number ending with the letter B. Typically, once we get to B or A, we're close to a final release, meaning I would expect iOS 16.4 beta 5 or more likely release candidate or iOS 16.4 RC as soon as Tuesday or Wednesday of next week. That seems to be the most likely, as I would expect Apple to release the final version of iOS 16.4 to the public, most likely on the 27th or 28th of March, to go along with Apple Music Classical. Now, Apple Music Classical doesn't require iOS 16.4, so they could push that anyway, but I think that seems likely, as we'll get that done by the end of March, and then move on to iOS 16.5 Beta 1 in early April. Now, sometimes Apple releases the first beta of the next version the day after the public release, or they wait a week. We just don't know these days with Apple, but I would expect it in the last week of March for iOS 16.4's public release, or the first week of April. That seems to make the most amount of sense. As far as iOS 17, well, we're expecting that in the first week of June for beta testers. Then we'll see that a few weeks later for public beta testers. We have developers first, then public beta testers. And we're also waiting for those WWDC invites. So the Worldwide Developer Conference 2023, or WWDC 23, is expected in the first week of June. We haven't seen those invites yet. Last year at this time, we already had them. So we're still waiting for them. Apple sometimes released it in April. Sometimes they've released it in March. We just don't know, but we're waiting for those invites. And they'll go out to different people in the press, and also different developers can sign up to be there. So we should see all of that along with those new OSs very, very soon, just a couple months away. Now, the overall experience of iOS 16.4 Beta 4 is much better. This is more like it and is a much better representation of what I expect from iOS. The stability's improved and most things are working properly now. One of those things is the battery widget. The glyphs are now there. I mentioned this in the initial What's New video, but the battery glyph has returned, where before it just had the circle, you didn't know what it was representing. Also, if we go into FaceTime, they fixed that. If you're in a FaceTime or maybe a Zoom call, you can see the icons have returned for video effects and also the mic mode. So that's showing again. And if you're using a third-party keyboard and using messages, sending photos and GIFs or GIFs is now working properly again. That's actually finally working as you would expect. And also the Apple Music delete bug has been fixed. So maybe you downloaded a song or added it to a playlist. Sometimes it would just disappear randomly or right after you play it. That's been resolved with Beta 4. The backtap bug has been resolved as well. Depending on what you set it on, if you used backtap to double tap the back of your phone, it would cause it to respring or basically do sort of a reboot. You'd see the Apple logo and then you would come back to the home screen. So that's been resolved. Apps are now opening properly again for me. With Beta 3, they would just crash. You'd open it up, it would crash immediately. Then you'd open it up again and it would work properly. You could reboot it and it would fix it, but now it seems to be fixed and that hasn't occurred again. Also, Bluetooth seems to be better for me, not only connecting to AirPods like I have here, but also connecting to my vehicle with my car keys, things like that. It seems to be a much better connection, less sort of static when you're connected, no issues there. So a much better experience. I still do have an issue with them on my Mac, and that's more of the Mac. I'm waiting for the update there, as that Mac's not running a beta. Also, storage seems to be much improved as far as using less space for the overall cache files. So if we go into settings again, and if we go down to the bottom of storage, you'll see system data here. And this is really just cache data, so not really anything to worry about, but it seems to be using a lot less, and maybe the OS is a little bit more efficient this time around, so it doesn't need it. So if you have a phone that's near its full storage capacity, this should be better. Let me know if it is for you in the comments below. Also, photos seems to be improved. It hasn't seemed to get gotten any worse for me, meaning that when you take a photo, sometimes it's overly processing and dark. So I'll turn off raw photos and let's turn off the lights here. Snap a photo, also take a screenshot and see if it represents the same thing. And from what I can tell, it looks pretty much the same as you see on your display is what you're getting. So let me know if you're experiencing the same thing. Apple hasn't said they fixed it, but there's been a lot of information out there from different creators such as MKBHD and others, and it seems to be resolved this time around. So hopefully it's better for you. Let me know in the comments below. There is one bug that seems to remain, and that has to do with notifications. So the notifications bug where you had squared off edges and then they would go to round, that seems to be fixed. However, scrolling through them sometimes is really choppy. And I can show you what that looks like in Twitter. And you can see here, this was sent over by Noah. So thanks for sending that. You'll see it's just really sort of stuttery. I'm not experiencing that, but some people are. And make sure you're reporting that in feedback if you're having that issue. He's already reported it, but just wanted to make sure you do if you're having issues as well. Now, as far as the overall battery life and battery health, let's go into settings again. We'll go back and go to battery. Now, my battery health overall is still at 98%. This is after 134 cycles, as you can see on Coconut Battery here. It's a Mac app that you have to install outside of the App Store. So if you're looking for that, that's where that is. And It's normal. 80% after 2 years is completely normal. Now, battery on beta 4 has been better than beta 3 for me. Yesterday, I had 4 hours of screen active time and 4 hours and 32 minutes of screen idle time and used about 75% of the battery. If we go back to when I was on beta 3, I used almost 100% of my battery and only had 3.5 hours. This still isn't great. Today is better at 2.5 hours and only about 25% used. So I'm at 77%, so close to 25% used. It's better than it was. It still isn't great for me. It could be some apps I have, and you can see my home and lock screen is using the most, phone and other things, but it seems to be getting a little better. Some people say it's a lot better. As far as overall performance, it's quite good. Very smooth, no issues here. I haven't had it slow down or stutter, and playing a song in music, if we swipe home, the dynamic island is nice and fast, no stutters there. It hasn't returned since beta 3, although it took a few taps to go back home there. So it seems to be much better than it was. Performance is great, and heat is great. I know some people are concerned as it's getting warmer out. The back of the phone is nice and cool for me, but let's take a look with the thermal camera. And at the hottest point, I'm seeing about 32 degrees Celsius. 32.4 is the highest I've seen. In Fahrenheit, I'm seeing 92.8, I think, is the highest I saw there. But in general, this isn't anything to worry about. I've mentioned this before. Apple runs their processors very hot. Processors get warm when they're just working normally, and that's why in some PCs you even have liquid cooling and other things. So I really wouldn't worry about it unless it's hot to the touch where you can't even hold on to it. I would probably ignore it. Overall, it's doing what it's supposed to do. Now, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 16.4 beta 4, well, I would probably wait until the release candidate if it's on your main device. Apple typically says don't run them on your main device, so if you're worried about bugs and things like that, I would hold off. Wait until the final release. If you have an extra phone, well then sure, you can try it, but make sure you have a backup and a computer so you can restore if you need to. Now let's take a look at some of your comments. iOS 16.4 beta 4 user on my 14 Pro Max, somehow still getting that annoying storage bug, and I feel the camera quality hasn't improved at all. Pictures still come out dimmer. Melina Mora, 5789, said using iOS 16.4 public beta 4 on my iPhone XR, and so far it's been pretty smooth. No app crashes or bugs, downloaded simply because of the new emojis, but I don't regret it. Zomboy 4313 says, "Hi Aaron, I'm running iOS 16.4 public beta 4 on my iPhone SE 2nd Gen. I can report that the Spotlight backtap bug has been fixed, where my iPhone would respring if I used backtap Spotlight in an app and then on the home/lock screen. Spotlight overall seems to be more responsive, but there is still no animation when prematurely exiting Spotlight on the lock screen. I hope that gets fixed soon. Your videos are always helpful and informative. Hope iOS only gets better from here." MVG180 says, "I'm running iOS 16.4 beta 4 on my iPhone 14 Pro Max, and I've had a great experience so far. ProMotion is smooth, no app crashes, resprings, or freezes. Hopefully we get the RC next week." And so that's everything with iOS 16.4 beta 4. If you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, we're all looking forward to the final release, hopefully within a couple weeks. Let me know your overall experience in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time. Now, if you've stayed this long into the video, thanks so much. I do plan to bring the music back very soon, but I wanted to ask what you would like to see in these videos in the future. Is there anything else you'd like for me to add or maybe just remove? News or anything else? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Thanks again for watching. I really appreciate it.